Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the last best of two here at the Star Series C qualifier. It's Fnatic versus Faceless. And I'm Luminous, and I'm joined by Yosin. And I gotta say, it's been a fun ride casting all of these C games for you guys. But we got two more to go. We're gonna start things off with a Shadow Demon plus Centaur. Going up against the Faceless combination of the Rubick and the Jab's Ember Spirit. Jab's been playing pretty well today. I don't think he's had a single game where the two of us weren't impressed with him.
Yeah, I mean, the first game he played, unfortunately, it was just like his entire team was losing, so you can't really fault him for that. But like you said, every other game, just dominating his lane for the most part, and only two heroes played today, right? It's just Ember and Invoke.
Yeah, maybe, you know, they're focusing a lot of attention on banning out, I think, Ice Zeros. Maybe you just ban out Jabs. See how the team, you know, deal with it. Because they are looking pretty good. Pretty good.
It's a tough call. It's kind of easy to say that after seeing how well they performed last game. Mm-hmm. But we have no comparison since we never get to see these Ice Heroes to begin with.
True. Now, it's not like Faceless leave Jabs alone. They definitely put a lot of help on him in the mid lane. I jokingly said tri-lane mid, but they literally tri-lane mid like twice in bro now. Whenever Ember has, or whenever Jabs has a very difficult matchup. Like, you know, Ember versus Ursa.
Yep, and he put it to good use. He just gets all that farm and then stomps everyone throughout the mid game.
Yep. Now we're going to see a XY Earth Spirit, which I believe in game one of their six game day today, he played it. And honestly, it was not the best Earth Spirit I've ever seen. I've seen him miss a lot of roll and kick combinations. Or maybe I'm just comparing it to Tim's. You know, not everyone could be Tim's Earth Spirit. No disrespect to XY. But, yeah, I'm sure he'll play it well here.
Yeah, I kind of agree with you there. But once again, it was like definitely just all together as a team, they were just all behind. So it's really hard to fault anyone, right? They just...
Right. That was the warm-up game. So, he's going to play super well.
That was the warm-up game. Yeah. Earth Spirit needs warm-up. Yep. He probably forgot to do his hero demo and then hitting all those Earth Spirit combos before a game starts.
Yo, that's the play. You can't do it during Captain's mode, huh?
You can disconnect and go do it.
Yeah. Alright.
I'm pretty sure you do it beforehand, right?
We got the Lone Druid. Yesterday played by Mushi. Today probably played by Mushi as well. And one thing that we noticed about the Lone Druid from Mushi yesterday was it was just not farmed. Compared to the Lone Druid we've been seeing, right? He's just constantly like an item and a half behind. Mushi, I think in that game, died once or twice in the laning stage, and that's really all you need to set a Lone Druid back, because honestly, the hero shouldn't really die early on. He's quite strong in the lane.
Yeah, to be fair, it was a lot of pressure on him.
Yep.
But I definitely agree with you there. Maybe just not too used to the ranged Lone Druid build just yet.
Not used to the extra range?
No, just playing it in general. Because a lot of Lone Druid players before this patch, it's always been about the bear.
The micro, right? Yeah.
And all of a sudden you find yourself, well, actually I don't have to micro anything. I just right click and then control my hero.
That's not true.
Okay, definitely not true, but yeah. It's a very different playstyle. It's not the same.
Yeah, I think the micro now is more focused on casting a good Savage Roar with your bear, which, you know, it's also on top of the traditional way to play Lone Druid, but less hands-on, as you will, with the new Lone Druid.
You know what I want to see from Fnatic? I just want to see them 10 seconds to go. Completely switch everything around. Like, they do the draft, and then when the draft finishes, they should all have a different role. Nah. That'll really throw off Faceless.
I mean, I don't think Faceless care what role whoever is playing. Yeah.
Because the draft itself, I would say, is fairly standard from what we've seen all day.
Yeah.
Nyx Assassin. This has been banned out against Faceless every single game.
Yes.
And but now we get to see it. It's like completely slips through.
I have to say, if there's one embodiment of a hero that embodies a hero, embodies a player, excuse me, it's Nyx Assassin for Ice. Because Just everything about this hero. It's sneaky, it comes out of nowhere, but has insane game impact. And even his flavor text, just Nyx Nyx Nyx. I just can imagine Ice saying that. And yeah, I mean, this is one of the more skill intensive heroes, because I think you pointed out yesterday, you really need to have a good lane stage, and it's just hard to get these days because you're laning against Lifestealer, you're laning against Luna, supports I could right click you for a ton of damage, easy setup Shadow Demon into Aero combination like every other game, but Ice, you will find a way. And last but not least, it's going to be the Klynx. Is that the answer to Lone Druid? Just massive damage to kill him?
It's actually a decent matchup. But it really depends. If Klynx is a decent start, like if he gets a free farm in his lane, it's actually very easy for him to just run around the map with a lot of the times I see people just get the Blightstone and then Soul Ring and you just start eating creeps everywhere, and it's more than enough damage to pick off someone like Lone Druid.
Ooh. Deathball time? I don't know, picking Chen into Klynx? Normally I thought it's the other way around.
It's a very good point.
Yeah. I mean,
free death pack in team fights.
True. I wonder if Klynx is going to buy a HOD. I've been seeing people kind of talk about that, to have a creep on you at all times. But not sure if it's worth the gold investment, as you do have to buy it, which delays your Deso or Orchid or whatever other item you might be going for.
HOD. Now that you mention it, I don't really like it too much.
Yeah. I mean, this game you probably don't need to, because Chen's going to feed you the creeps for free. So, good stuff.
10 seconds to go.
Although, I want to say having that Satyr Purge when you're going for these ganks with Klynx is not bad. Not bad at all.
You know, I think one thing to note is OD is... Isn't OD one of Mushi's specialties?
Yeah.
Oh, look
wait, wait!
See? What did I tell you?
Wait, no. It's just two heroes swapped up. I think they wanted to swap. They're pinging him out. But you can't swap outside the base. I think you need to swap in the fountain.
What?
I think Febby picked the wrong hero. And now Fade wants to swap. But you can't swap when you're...
They paused.
What's happening, guys?
He disconnected.
Okay.
Ohio disconnects. And then they're going to say he can't reconnect, and then we're going to go into a remake.
Nah.
I'm calling it right now.
Am I wrong? Can you pause?
Maybe we will see it.
Can you swap outside of the base?
You're supposed to be able to.
Okay. All right. Then maybe I'm wrong.
You never griefed your teammates before like this?
No, I'm not a griefer. What the fuck?
Well, anyways... Yeah, see? Look at the little here it comes.
Are they logging onto each other? No, wait. You don't need to log onto each other. Can they just switch seats? We saw a Chinese team just do this, because the game...
But it's a different setup. It's very different when you don't have your own setup.
No. They literally unplugged their mouse and keyboards, and they changed...
Oh, and then switch seats?
Yeah, they changed all the game setting. It took them like 10 minutes to do this.
They might be doing that now? Very interesting early game. Oh, what was I talking? Oh, I was talking about the swapping. So you could, I've been griefed by this before. Where
you, sure
you know how when
you
ask someone to swap?
Uh-huh.
I've been griefed by this. Yeah. Okay. So you ask someone to swap, right?
They say okay.
And they say okay. And what they do is they wait for you to offer the swap, and then they don't accept it. Then they offer you the swap and wait for you to accept it. And then they buy all their items, and then they TP into a lane and run next to the tower, and they hit OK, and then it swaps you. And then you feed.
Why would anyone do this?
When you're playing with your friends, sometimes you get trolled.
I see. What's with
all this creep? They don't do it. I mean, obviously, this isn't in ranked.
I mean, I have no friends, so that never happens to me.
Okay, yeah, that's fine then. That's the counter.
Oh, bad strat. I have no friends. Immune to that bullshit. They are probably switching computers right now.
Yeah, they're probably switching. I think you're right. They should be switching.
Unless they're just reading into it and Svebby playing. Who knows?
I like to say that isn't the case, but we never really know. But since we have nothing better to talk about, we might as well speculate.
It's actually so nice that our last best of two is going to begin with the long pause. It reminds me of your theory of the sandbag Doto.
Ah.
Sandbag casting, sorry.
Yeah. You have to endure it. It's the only way you improve. And the best way to improve is to push through the tough situations. Let's just take a... We should just look at effigies, see if anyone has anything funny.
Effigies? Does anyone even equip effigies anymore?
Yeah, all of them do.
I haven't even made an effigy yet. I don't have time for that shit. Febby says, best hero in game has a picture of Anti-Mage. You can't even look at them anymore. What the...
I can't see him anymore. Alright, some of it is in Chinese. I can't even read this.
Quap O, Queen of Pain. Pain of Gain. What is this? Is this supposed to be a disruptor? What is this? Oh, no.
Wait, which one are you looking at?
I'm looking at Dire Base right now, the top right one. Is this Luna? Or is this Mirana?
It looks like Mirana.
Alright, looks like we're going.
It's Mirana.
Okay, I assume this is Febby on Chen. That's gonna be my assumption. Can you all chat? It's like, is Febby playing Chen?
I don't know if it's.
They will reply if it's the next on champion.
Oh, look. Oh. See, when have you ever seen a mid start with these items? Yeah, they swap. Look at this.
Yeah.
Oh, is this what you want from your mid player? To start with forced. This is unprecedented for a mid to start with nothing but four iron branches.
It's precedented. It's been done before.
Like. I mean, with absolutely nothing else. This is all he has.
He's got two. Yeah, it's fine. What happened to his gold?
Because it was the courier was already bought out as well, and then he TP'd out. And here we go. Right,
so that was a TP. Oh shit!
With a set of Tengos and two clarities, he doesn't even get full value back from him. That's rough.
That's why you just hit swap, man. Right, so I assume Faded is playing on the OD, but I'm probably going to make that mistake a couple of times. Febby's going to have some extra gold on Chen, but Chen does not need the extra gold, so... You know. Oh,
hey,
looks like
the carry.
Thinking about grabbing a creep and going for a smoke gank immediately, but this is not the creep to go for. Is this the return of the double jungle Chen?
Don't look down on the Wildkin.
As a gank.
Tornado's OP. Yeah, Tornado's OP.
Okay. So do you pop the smoke right now? Oh my god, yes you do.
Oh, nuts.
Yo, he knows.
But they dodged.
Okay, but he can roll away.
He just got it out.
And they really need Centaur stuns to actually make this work. Alright. So I just want to say today, the only time that Faceless has lost a game today is when Execration won offensive trialing against them. And just shut down Black. Well, in fact, I think they won all three lanes that game.
Well, they Fnatic are off to a good start to winning this tri lane.
Tornado.
Win with Tornado.
Okay. I guess. That Tornado is the slowest moving twister I've ever seen.
It's fine. It's gonna do its job. Look at this. This is how you win the lane. With Chen.
Alright, Black getting wrecked. Oh, wait! Febby, be careful with that micro.
Excuse me, it's Faded?
Okay, fine, I'll call them Faded.
Yeah. We can't be jumping into conclusions.
My bad.
We're better than that.
Okay.
So let's see how Febby adapts to the mid lane.
You fool well, damn no, that's not Febby. But okay.
Excuse me? His name is Febby. This is clearly Febby playing the Obsidian Destroyer. Oh, sorry, Outworld Devourer.
Top lane Mushi's gonna get rolled on. That's a double damage rune here. Impale's gonna miss by Ice.
He dodges. Now, no tower drawer though.
Focus on nuts and
easy kill on nuts.
Just walk away, dude. Walk away. Get the kill. First blood goes to Mushi, first, and now yeah. Teleport's
gonna
come
be
in.
More. He's fine. He's got the spike carapace.
Yeah, Mushi getting first blood. Nice.
Decent start so yeah. far. You know, I'm actually kind of convinced that it might actually be Febby.
Why? Why would you not be convinced?
Well, because I don't ever see this build from Faded for OD.
Yeah, because you had to buy the courier.
Well, we'll never know.
I mean, you can know. You could. You should next on champion power and ask.
I'm not asking.
Okay. Well, Ohio's kind of going down, but it's not so bad. They took down a tier 1 already.
They took down a tier 1, yeah.
I guess the downside now is that the Klings has, like, more room to farm, I suppose. That's one way to look at it.
Just gonna have to wait and see for that level 6 Klings. There's a lot of different ways people have been playing Klings, but I still think that the best Klings player, to me at least, is Fear. When he played carry for EG.
Yes.
I think his style of playing Klinks is definitely the best. And I'm pretty sure Black will draw from that.
Well, I think the reason that he was able to play like that is that kind of playstyle, you don't farm a lot. You actually put a lot of pressure on the map, but because he had Arteezy as a more of a farming oriented mid, he was able to do that. Now we've seen Jabs being able to take that role. I think it's more of like whether Black is gonna play that more like selfless kind of role, if you will, and gank and pressure for the team.
It's definitely a very possible option here.
Disruption is going to fly out, and that's after Impale, so Ice is really stuck here for good. Of course you get the first hit root, but the spike does actually get a Ravage off, but not going to be enough.
Febby mid lane, they catch him out. Alright, Febby goes down.
I could hear
everything.
I could hear the purpose in your words when you say Febby.
Yep.
All right, Glyph is gonna get used. Disruption is gonna find him again here. Uh oh. There's gonna be a spike. Where's the clap? And now Tower is focused on Faded. Nice kick coming through. It's gonna be a two-man stun.
Oh, is he gonna reach it?
Mushi. Oh. Mushi did not have that the RNG.
It might have been a kill if he hit that root, actually.
Oh, the bear, though.
Stun?
Walk that bear. Walk it. Wait, Mushi? Mushi? Now he's in trouble. He's blocking for his bear. He's gonna plop the rapid. Oh, that was a bait, dude.
Alright, it's fine. It's fine. All in all, that was actually pretty good for Faceless, if you ask me. Because Ice is getting a lot from this offlane. He's already hit level 6. That's pretty damn impressive, actually.
Yep, has a current Arcane Boot as well. I mean, is Nyx a good hero in this game, though? Because I feel like against any Chen-based lineup, the group up and push is going to be fast and furious. And I don't think Nyx is the best hero for that until you get the Aghanim Scepter. Mid lane Jabs. Thinks he's going on Febby, and he is. But here comes Ohio. It's going to be a two-man who's something going to turn it on XY. XY, first one to go down Jabs. Going to get Astral as well. That's going to reset that cooldown to double edge if they're going to go for a Jabs out of Flame Guard. And okay, nice fire. That shall be it. And you do see players opting to level up Arcane Orb more and only reserving the 1 point Astral Imprisonment, especially against Ember. Because your orb hits through the thing, the Flame Guard.
Oh, top lane. They're going on Ice. Can he root?
Of course he can. Stampede's going to get used as well, and now Nuts might be in a little bit of trouble here. Okay, Ice trying to walk it off. The right clicks are fast and furious. He goes and visits. Dust is going to be here and they re-right click him. Impale is going to hit on... Okay, the TP coming in from Black, but denied on the neutral. Now ADTR is being focused. I think Mushi could just walk away with this with phase boots. And ADTR is going to go down. Mushi.
Just wasting their time.
Did Mushi lose his bear?
Oh, and mid lane. Going down to the Ember Spirit. Solo kill.
Okay. How did that even happen?
triple remnant. Something, something triple remnant.
Was there astral use?
He had to use it. He used it defensively. He astraled himself. I think what happened was he saw that the triple remnant was coming in, and he probably tried to dodge it, but
he missed.
Just didn't. Yeah, he missed. That's my guess. I didn't see exactly how the fight started.
XY is gonna rotate in from the right side. Don't have the triple remnant on deck here, but Yodi is not exactly the tankiest hero, so. XY is going to come in, goes right into the Chen army. They have net available, but the net apparently does not actually prevent the roll away. I'm not sure. Okay, it gets disrupted on the back line. Ohio's going to get up the stun, and that's going to be a kill. This is a whole new different Fnatic. I got to say, Faded playing the support Chen has created so much opportunity. His playstyle looks very, very like Febby's, but it's not Febby, so I'm not going to call him Febby.
Black. Maybe this is his specialty hero, and he thought, you know, this is where we need it.
Yeah, sure. Black's gonna pop a strafe here against Mushi. Mushi's gonna just right click. He knows he's actually getting ganked from the back line. Just runs away from this gank. Somehow they have vision, but Mushi. Oh, he's gonna turn around for the right click. Oh no, Mushi! You could have survived. Bottom lane here. Jabs. Gonna get double Brennan in, but not gonna be enough here. He's dropping a ton of HP, but not gonna be enough. And Dumb Illusion Rune's actually going to work here.
Killing off the creep, too. Yeah.
Man, why are they so tanky?
Well, he does have 1,000 life. It's pretty decent.
Alright, now, Klinks. Doing what Klinks is good at. Pressuring these tier 1 towers. Oh god.
Jabs finds another kill. Not triple remnanting this time.
I just moved my camera away for a second. That was where the kill was. My bad, guys.
Alright, Ice, he has his ult. He's gonna opt to continue farming up here.
You know the funny thing this game is that the Klinks has ganked more than Ice has.
Maybe that's the play. Make space for your offlane Nyx to pick up that Midas into Scepter as early as possible.
Yo, he's also going for the no mana burn build. It's like there's this agreement that mana burn's not the play.
Tough one. They want to go for this.
They have the defensive disruption. They need a way for him to push out a little bit more if they're going to try to make this play. Yeah, Klinks is already gone. In fact, Ice wants to go for the support in the backline, which he is correct. There is one. But without...
He needs to follow up though. There's no mana burn on him.
Yeah,
so
without
he
mana
have
burn.
Damage.
I mean, even with mana burn, I don't think he solo kills.
Oh, here we go. Oh!
Disruption. But now ADTR is going to get hit on the backline. They have Stampede available.
And Black's just out. Call it off. This is definitely the right play to just leave because Dark Death Pack ran out as well.
Okay, Ohio loses quite a bit of HP here using that double edge. But Jabs don't want to go in. Jeff's just farming in the safe lane now. Straight up the tower, giving his mid lane the support.
He's doing it like pretty aggressively too. I think he realizes there's just really no way he's gonna die here.
Yeah. I mean, what's their method to gank him? Disruption into a stun,
just
I guess?
Disruption into stun.
Oh, that was an easy setup. Kill. I think the reason he feels that he can play this aggressive is because of Klinks is running around, providing a ton of like information and vision.
And this is exactly how the Klinks fear plays out as well.
Yep.
Black's doing a very good job just running all over the place. And you still end up farming a decent amount because Death Pack is essentially killing off a creep.
Yeah, not only that, because Klinks is so good at removing these towers, that early boost in terms of net worth for your team and for yourself is quite key. He does get the tower last hit, which is I think the critical component to kind of staying farmed. This playstyle is actually really, really nice. Like, it's very a selfless playstyle. It makes your team look very good, but you're just like the centerpiece of all the action, and you're able to, you know, get a lot of things done.
And here we go, walking around again. He finds out Chen I think another thing to note too is the amount of amount of money they're putting into centering all over the place.
Oh, Fnatic. Gonna be a little bit of trouble here. It's gonna be a lift into a kit. Okay. I mean, Mushi's very, very tanky in this form, but I don't know if he's tanky enough. Yeah, it looks like he's gonna go down. No, Hand of God's gonna come in. They can Astro him if they want to. No Astro on Mushi, but why no Astro on Mushi?
Not sure.
Yeah.
The engagement's not over yet.
And now he gets spiked. And now he's dead. All disruption.
Oh, not yet.
Sendback? I think he's home. He's not home. Wasn't there a sendback on him, or did I look wrong? I guess I was wrong. And now Chen's gonna get found here in the woods. Chen only level 6 without Hand of God. He's also dead. It's almost a full team wipe, guys.
It wasn't even a team fight. It was just people everywhere. One by one. Alright, OD is going for the farming route. They're relying on farming into the late game. Midas is going to be the item of choice here. I don't know how I feel about this, though. It feels like their team fight is incredibly weak because of this.
I think they need to make sure they are grouping up as 5. Because the faceless lineup is at their perfect strength when everyone is trying to farm. Right? You have Klings and Nyx. Like, they're just gonna gank you for days.
It's tough, though, because you're in that position where, while it is true that faceless pickoff is really strong, at the same time, Fnatic doesn't exactly have the greatest team fight either.
That's true. I mean, all of the team fight is just Centaur.
Well, there's also Hand of God. There's not even Sanity's Eclipse right now either.
Yeah. Well, I'm gonna say that if Fnatic's looking to farm, they're not gonna farm faster than Faceless.
Ohio, he has a Blink Dagger. Is he gonna catch up Nuts here?
Okay, Finds Nuts.
Easy kill.
Where's the double edge? Oh, he gets Astral! He wanted to, like, an extra hit into a double edge. Now he gets lifted up. This is a very chaotic team by Stamp. He's gonna get used, but immediately gets stunned out. Cheatman stunned, and on the back line is gonna be Magnetize being dropped up. It looks like that was more or less a feat, but here comes the cavalry on the back line, getting backstabbed by Black Mushi. He's gonna run to the right side, pops himself immediately here, and he's gonna port home. Okay, that wasn't actually so bad here for Fnatic.
That wasn't bad at all, yeah. I think there's a lot of miscommunication from both sides, actually. Yeah.
I mean, as soon as the Ember and Klings came from the backline, I thought they were just all going to be dead. But they kind of just ran in different directions, and it was okay. But regardless, though, Faceless...
They still get a T1.
Yeah, defended their own Tier 1, they got a T1, so still a big victory here for Faceless.
And I think Fnatic are still not that strong in terms of team fight, because the Lone Druid only has a Dragon Lance. Ooh, interesting to see. Chen is going for the first item, Scepter. Curious to see how this plays out.
I mean, if you want to go late, right? This is the build. I'm gonna say that very commonly, you finish the Scepter before you even get level 18, so you won't be able to maximize the Ancient Creep Domination.
I actually haven't seen the new Ancient Creep being used.
The Ancient Prowler?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's okay. It's alright.
Alright, Fnatic.
Ooh, Black comes around, goes for the Courier. Gotta disrupt him.
Might go down for it.
Oh, they can't actually get off any of the spells, but then they do get the Demonic Purge.
That's a very, very good trait for Fnatic.
Look at this army.
He got stomped from everything.
Yep. If Mushi's Bear could have stomped, it would have stomped too.
He had like 7 units above him.
Yeah. Nuts, gonna just walk in.
Nuts is insane!
Yo, okay, because it was actually a setup play by his team, and now it's gonna be Nyx getting a kill here. Now, Fire Remnants gets jumped in, of course. Ohio's gonna get sent back.
Is he gonna make it? It's a very long one, yeah.
He's fine. And then Chen gets picked off. So that's gonna be a 3-4-0 exchange. With Nuts walking up, pretending like he's a noob.
Easy bait.
J- debated.
Oh, I see why. It's because he had Astral. Yeah.
No, he walked up to steal Astral. He didn't even have Astral. Okay. He could have got wrecked.
But he didn't.
But he didn't. On the back line here, Ohio gets caught. He's trying really hard to get off that Houston, but he's just getting continuously chain stunned from like a mile away. And that's gonna be tier 2, guys.
Jabs is so farmed. He's just making all these kills happen because he has that blink dagger. Yep. So mobile.
If he sees you, he could get you before you see him. Like, thanks to the ward behind the tower. Which is what happened there to Ohio.
Only downside to this draft is without black, this tower damage is incredibly awful.
Actually, no one's hitting it except for Jabs.
But tower. They do a lot of damage though. Yeah.
I wonder why Black did not rotate over. I know he was shoving in top as well, but
actually, not too sure. Yeah. Well, he's almost got the Desolator.
Is 24 damage versus the tower better than 2 armor reduction on the tower?
I will go ahead and say yes, it's better.
Okay. I don't know.
Considering our tower has 22 armor, I'm just guessing. I mean, someone's gonna have to crunch the numbers. I'm just gonna guess.
Someone will correct you in Twitch chat.
Yep.
Or correct me in Twitch chat. Either case. So the more and more I've seen of Centaur, I feel like he might not be as strong as everyone thinks he is. Like, on the games where you're winning, Centaur O is just amazing. But when you're losing, it's not that strong of a ult. It's like you're just running
I think
away.
You really notice the strength of him when he finishes Scepter. Until then, he's kind of just like your very standard, kind of almost like a Slardar replacement.
Sure. Well, I say even weaker than a Centaur Slardar replacement, because you don't have Corrosive Haze.
Yeah, definitely. And you don't move at a 400 plus movement speed.
Yeah.
But this looks really bad for Fnatic. You drafted a Chen lineup and a Lone Druid together.
No. This
all
is
you have is one tier 1.
Farming late game. The funny thing is they took that tier 1 at like 3 minutes in.
Right.
And then since then it's just like...
Alright, we're going to see an engagement.
Black just kills people. But now, Nyx66. Oh, Blink Hoofstomp, but now he's in a lot of trouble. Stolen Stampede as well, of course. Nuts is going to make that play. Now it's going to be Remnant against Febby. Febby's going to be dead here.
One by one, everyone on Fnatic just goes down.
Yep. Actually, one by one.
Team wipe.
Alright. Arrow drawn from mid lane. No, they want bottom instead.
Why did they draw out the line then?
I think some... I drew the line and then somebody said, bottom! Get the shrine then. Black's gonna hit some creeps. Black really needs to be at this tower because it's actually not dropping without Black.
Well, he's going for the bigger objective, the tier 3 mid. Look how much damage he got on it.
Yeah. Casually take half your tower's HP. Oh, Demonic Purge. Thank you.
Oh, he's still taking the mid.
Yeah.
Look at that damage.
That's a kill. That's gonna be tower.
And that's your Hand of God as well.
Yep. Oh god. That's a quarter of his HP in one hit. Okay, Astral's gonna find him. Silence on 2. No kick though. Febby? It's gonna be okay. The Raxus though, not gonna be okay. Nice 2-man. Root Hoofstomp's gonna be there as well. They're gonna focus on Black. Ton of damage output. They need a Sanity's Eclipse. They got it off, and that's gonna be good damage. Meanwhile, that's gonna be an Ember start. Trapped in it. Jabs out of the flame part. Ohio needs to hit the stun. Oh, he gets lifted by Jab. Nuts.
Sealed the Stampede.
Oh my god. Is that the second seal? Okay. Nice kick. XY is gonna roll away now, but Disruption is gonna find the Nyx Assassin. Ohio moving forward. Okay. They stun each other, but on the back line, it's gonna be Ember Spirit. Everyone's super low. If Jabs could get off his Flame Guard, he has Slight in 1 second. Jumps in. That's a triple so far. And he has Slight. He has Blink. Don't take it, XY. Okay, he took it. Wait, there's more though.
Oh, he doesn't hit the
Blink.
Ooh, he didn't use his mana for the Blink Guard. Oh, he got it.
Got it. Yeah, that's fine.
Alright. XY took away Jab's Rampage, but it's okay.
Reported.
What is Ohio gonna do with this buyback? Can you even stop him? He's gonna get kited by this blink dagger. Luckily for him though, Jabs does no damage, really. 135.
Well, without mana. Without mana. But he's getting some mana back down.
Well, on the bright side, Fnatic do hold their melee racks. They only lose their range racks.
Yeah. Well, as well as all the shrines that Black now walk across the map and take.
My goodness, Jabs is level 21 at 23 minutes.
A minute or level?
Minute or level, yeah. It's got that Mjolnir.
Oh, I feel for this.
Alright, they find the pickoff. Yeah. Two pickoffs.
Make that. Who's three. This Astral? Oh, Centaur.
Ohio.
Stolen ult. Nuts. Nuts had a spell steal on cooldown. Oh my god. That was too close. He's not TP though. He needs to keep running. Nuts is not even gonna hunt for him now.
Alright, here we are at the mid lane again. This is definitely gonna be a melee Rex.
Okay, blink and pale that bear. Oh my god, that bear. Where did it go?
Well, here's your answer about Klinks. You're wondering if it was a good pick against a lone druid.
Oh, come
on.
He's
fine.
This game. I don't know if it's fair to make the comparison now. Dyer's lost the top tower.
Oh, Blink Stomp. Ice Sights. He's gonna get off.
Might actually die. No! He's fine. Spike Carapace. The Shrine's healing everyone decently, though, but Jabs doesn't care. He's actually just going in. Chen's dead. ADTR is probably gonna get blinked on. Of course. A nice place that he blinked on, and he's gonna go home and get some mana.
So stylish.
Yep. Dire's top rags is in trouble. Can't do nothing about Dire's structures right now. Oh, Mushi, not like this.
Oh. Roar? Yeah, he's dead. And I think that's game one.
I agree.
Without a doubt. Top rags is all the pieces. Oh, okay. Seems like Fnatic thought the same at the same time.
Yo, look at this!
Oh, look at that damage. Oh, he actually kills three of them in the fountain. Alright.
Had a Dagon, man.
Ember is insane.
Yeah, Ember is insane.
Alright, good stuff from Faceless. You know, even though they don't have a chance of qualifying, still showing that they definitely deserve to be one of the strongest in C.
Yeah, I really like the initial play from Fnatic. They put up a ton of pressure, got the early tower, and was able to rotate around the map. But as the game went on, I feel like there was a couple of mistakes. There were so many team fights in the jungle where people just die one by one. Granted, it's super hard to keep track of both Nyx and Klinks, especially when you start to lose the tier 1 towers. They could just be everywhere. And that's kind of what happened.
I can't get over the... how funny these after game rankings are, like the ratings.
Okay.
Jabs is 16-0-10. How is he not like 10 out of 10 for fighting, for example?
I mean, I think the bottom is more accurate, right? Like.
Okay. Yeah, that's true.
In a pro game.
Above average.
In a pro game, he's got 400 more XPM than his normal play.
He has 1,000 XPM. That's like something else.
Yeah.
That shouldn't happen.
Well, a level a minute, right? But unfortunately, he needs to assist his team more. He's actually not a team player. Alright guys, Game 2 is going to be coming up next, and that's going to be the final game here at the Star Ladder C-Series. Hopefully we'll see you there.